Okay, we're on location. I'm speaking to a lighting cameraman by the name of Pete Burns, and we've got a fantastic location. We're in a cinema in Nottingham called the Broadway Cinema. So thanks very much to the guys for letting us use this. One of the reasons I wanted to do this interview with you is because you were speaking to me about the Fellonis. I'd seen some techniques that you've been using with the Fellonis,
yep.
Bouncing them and using them in different situations. Let's have a talk about the Fellonis and what it is that makes these LED lights special.
I didn't rush into buying LED technology. I tested a few first. In fact, I bought a couple and sent them back. Some of the lights I tested, they had pretty nasty colour shift on dimming. I mean, this is just amazing. It just holds the colour all the way through. It's very impressive. I think Dedo just hit the nail on the head when they started to distribute these lamps. They're very lightweight. I'm now lighting in areas that I wouldn't normally light because I wouldn't have time being battery operated. I'd done a shoot the other day, for example. It was in a barn, had two of these going, and so I was filming for about 7.5 hours. They were on for about 7.5 hours, and they used about a battery and a quarter. That's amazing, amazing power consumption. It's definitely changed the way I'm lighting because now it's a lot quicker. I could set something up, you know, in a couple of minutes, straight out the bag, on a light stand, and there's no cables, you know, to worry about, people, trip hazards, all this sort of stuff, especially in a dark area like this, for example. We're mostly on batteries here, I think. Yeah, we are, yeah. Felloni is really powerful. It's battery operated, which is great, which means I can take it places I normally wouldn't. It also means I can react very quickly. Sometimes I want to get a kicker on, say, a reporter doing a piece of camera or something. Within about 2 minutes, out on the stand, sandbag on the tripod, there it is, looks fantastic. Previously, you know, you'd have to have power or Jenny or something, which you wouldn't do in that situation, let's face it. So you'd take the easy option, not use it. Felloni's great for that. And a lot of the time as a kicker, just talking about as a kicker, it's not even on full power. I mean, there's full power, that's very bright. But as a kicker, you're looking about sort of 40%, about a metre and a half away, you know, in daylight, and it really works well. Other situations, I've had people, the camera assistant recently, follow me around with it on a monopod, using it as a mobile fill light, which worked really well.
Talk to me about which Felloni's you actually bought, because I know they distribute the bicolour Felloni's, where you can balance for daylight or tungsten, or you can get tungsten, or you can get daylight Felloni's. And what sort of things did you think about when you made your decision on what to purchase?
My specific requirements, I wanted power, really high intensity, the best you could get, really. So I went just for the daylight. My thinking behind that one was, if I need to use it in a tungsten environment, I can drop a bit of CT on it. It's easier to drop CT on, but if you start off with a, let's say the tungsten isn't quite as bright, I believe, as the daylight version, you can't sort of up the power of the tungsten. It's nice to start with more power and bring it down than it is. You can't obviously go the other way. So my choice was the two daylight versions.
And when you go out on location, what do you tend to bring with you? Obviously, it's going to change from job to job, but do the Felloni's always go in because they're just so useful?
The Felloni's are in all the time. Prior to Felloni's, I would be lighting with, it was a reefer light and a data kit. That was the main interview lighting kit. Reefer's a fantastic light, great light source coming off it. The problem is it takes a long time to cool down. And this was an amazing sort of discovery when, you know, I found the Felloni, just sort of take it off the stand, put it away, it's fine. So typically now I'm using two Felloni's and say three Dedos. Very occasionally I'll just use one Felloni because that's all I need.
Yeah.
It's pointless over lighting something. Yeah, the other interesting thing about these lamps is that the bulbs just never go. You know, they've got thousands of hours on, unlike you know, traditional tungsten bulbs or very expensive HMIs. They're just absolutely amazing, they just keep going and going. What Dedo has nailed is a colour shift. There is no colour shift when you dim. I mean, that's the main point for me. Second point would be they're extremely lightweight. You can put them all sorts of places, hang them overhead. You don't need masses of weights on the end of the booms and things. They're very, very lightweight, even for handheld work. That's what impressed me about the Felloni.
A couple of things that interest me particularly, because I read this on your blog, is how you use these lights. I saw you doing a setup where you actually bounced it. I saw another setup, you sent me a picture where you've got two mounted together.
Yeah.
And it's quite an innovative approach, some of what you've been doing with it. It may have been done traditionally with other lights, but to be see it done with these lights, I've never seen some of these things before with the more modern lights, particularly LED.
What you're particularly talking about, I used a sunbounce, California sunbounce. I think it was a micro one. They're about 24 inch or something like that. And I had the idea one day of just sort of bouncing the Felloni off that. It was a piece I was doing with a reporter, Ivan Gaskell, outside a football stadium. And it was dusk, and it was just a nice that nice time of night. And I said, let's get something a bit softer, you know. So I set that up. And again, that was on 60%. I recall it. I couldn't believe it, because I actually turned it down, 60%. And it was just a way of making the softer light a bigger source, really. That's how I saw it. I was thinking more about making them look sort of decent rather than just illuminating them.
But that's the whole trick. Anyone can point lights.
Yeah, yeah.
It's about using them intelligently and creating a result. Mm. And by turning a small light source into a much bigger light source, it creates the reflections in the eyes. It's got a lot of, you know, overall softening.
Yeah,
the light is absolutely beautiful. Something else that impressed me, you sent me a photograph of putting two lights together on a bar to actually increase the output. Let's see what you got. You tell me how you made this one work.
The intensity I keep talking about is really powerful from one Felloni. And when I got the two of them, I just tested them on light stands, and I couldn't believe the power when they were overlapped. So I suddenly thought it would be neat to actually do away with one of the stands and get a T-piece. So eventually, after dredging the internet, I found one of these things. I honestly can't remember who makes them, and it cost me, I think, about 20 quid or something. But it's got two sort of connectors on there, and it fits on beautifully, the two lamps on one light stand. It just does the trick amazingly.
Do you use it very much? And what situations do you need that higher output for?
I've used it, to be honest, I've used it twice so far. And the situation I would use it was to bring the light level up in a room. It wasn't interviews or anything, it was actually just bringing the whole light level up. Then I would go in with the dados and do the nice stuff.
Okay, Pete, now I want to see you do some setups. I can see you've got one on the bar already. Let's mount this one on the bar and see what can be done. And just talk us through a little bit of, you know, the fact that it increases the light output and just how effective this is for you.
Yeah, well, I picked this up on eBay after dredging the internet for a long time. It's a little T-bar. And basically allows me to have two lamps on, as you said. And I wouldn't use it for sort of interviews or anything, but forget the light level up, generally a light level up. They're fantastic. If I switch them on, you can see the result it has. It's pretty powerful.
That's serious
light, as I say.
I'd love to know what that actually equates to if you compared it to a red or something.
I've never put a meter across it yet, but I think it's pretty impressive. It might be, I don't know, equivalent to a 575 bounce off the bit of poly something like that. I'm not sure, but it's powerful stuff.
And the fact that you can dim it, you can get just what you want.
Yeah.
It's like and very controlled.
These are the bicolour ones. So if there were two daylight ones on, you'd probably get another, I won't say percentages, but perhaps another 15% of power. I don't know. You'd have to check that one. But yeah, very impressive.
Think if you had to go back to using the lights that you were using, say, in the mid-80s, the traditional lights is what I'm trying to say.
Mm.
How much would that take away from what you can do with all these other wonderful tools that have developed since Dedo's been doing the 150s, the 100s, the Felloni's, and all of his wonderful portable lights?
I think going back to, say, using Fresnels and blondes and reds, one of the biggest problems I always had was light spillage. So although you might just have sort of, you know, four or five lights out, you've got a mass of flags and all sorts trying to control that light. It's bouncing everywhere. Using Dedo's, you know, the precision's there. It's just you put the light where you want it, and it's fantastic. I mean, even on these, there's a grid that comes on. It's a magnetic grid that just sort of goes onto the front of it. In fact, are we using one somewhere?
We got
I think we're using one at the back, actually, as a backlight, yeah.
Yep.
And that's amazing. Once you get the grid on, you can really control that soft light. Soft light is notoriously uncontrollable without lots of flags and stands and things. This grid is really useful. It takes the wide soft beam and turns it into quite a narrow beam. If we try, have a look down here at the seats first. We'll put the Felloni on, and you can see how wide that actually is on the seats. So it pretty much covers all four seats. If I put this on now, just click it on, and have a look again. It's actually quite narrow. It's probably about half the width of the original Felloni, which makes it great for backlights or even as a key, where you don't want any light to spill onto a background. And of course, the other thing with these is you're not frying your talent. You know, that is, it's not even warm. You know, it's very bright, but it's not warm at all. Take it away, switch it off, straighten the box, away you go. There's no chance of bulbs blowing up and things as the reds used to, etc. Explosive bulbs. That doesn't happen anymore. And even the Dedo light heads, they cool very quickly as well.